Hey guys, how's it going? So I probably only have about 5 minutes to record this video because we're down at the lake. Oh, the sun's not coming out, so I'm just going to put my sunglasses back on. We're down at the lake, but Ava's slowly waking up, and I just wanted to record this video. So 4 weeks in, and to be honest, this has been a weekly summary of what's been going on here with Ava as a new mom, and I wanted to share my journey with you, the pretty, the not so pretty, and of course the joys of it all. So this is a not so pretty video, I would say. And yeah, you can see I haven't washed my hair either. So pretty much week one and two was just literally focusing on mastering breastfeeding and recovering. That's all that was. And it was brilliant. Loved it. Lived in my PJs. Didn't get out of the house. Got out of the house a couple times, but it wasn't a mandatory thing. It was just if literally we had to, then we went out. But it wasn't, a focus of mine. Week three, though, I had a breakdown. Okay, week three, it was like, holy crap, she's demanding, can I do this, blah, blah, blah. And that will be another video on it. This is week four now, and honestly, this has been, and it's only been the last couple days, but I'm just being honest about how I've been feeling, is not the demanding, but and not kind of feeling alone, but it's actually been a test of, adult interaction. You're talking to a baby all day long, and you're on your own, which is fine. Honestly, nothing to do about, oh, Mick needs to be home and take off work. No, it's actually the complete opposite. It's actually just me adapting. And to be honest, today it was, she was crying, and I was like, we still have to get out of the house, Ava. I need to go for a walk. You need fresh air. We have to get out of the house. We can't be cooped up in here. And even yesterday, we went for a walk in the mall because it was really cold out. So we just went out and walked around the mall. And that was just to get out for my own sanity and not to say the newborn dictate what we're going to do, because it's not about not listening to their needs and neglecting them. It's nothing about that at all. It's also listening to your own needs and what you need. And I honestly needed to get out of the house. I needed to go for a walk. I needed fresh air. I needed adult interaction. Even if it was talking to the coffee cashier host, seriously, that's what I need it, and this is what I need it today. So that's why, we're out here, and we're gonna cut this very short because she's already been out for half an hour. And this is just a side note as well. I've already been probably walking for about close to 40 minutes, and I probably overdid it with my stitch. So, and I feel like I learned this lesson already, but it was walking for an hour. It was with underwear on. I know it's a little bit extra detail, but I felt like with the material friction was really irritating it. And that was with hill workout, with weights on my ankles as well. And that was an hour, and I did way too much. I could feel it. Where now today, I'm wearing ankle weights, but it's all flat. It's no hills, no underwear. And I'm still feeling it though. So I think it's with weights on, I think I have to cap it to 30 minutes. Unfortunately, I still have to walk 20 more minutes to get to the car, but I just walk slower steps, keep moving the material. And then once we get home, I'll have a salt bath and milk it from there. So, that's what I'll do to heal it. But I wanted to make this video to kind of hopefully relate to any new moms that have felt that, where they're just kind of like, oh my God, I'm cooped up indoors. I'm talking to a baby all day long. And I don't do baby talk. Okay, I actually talk to her just like a human, just like the way I want to be talked to, just for my own sanity. But I communicate with her. And I feel like, today it was just like, Amber, stop it. Just stop it. And if you haven't watched that video about stop it, I'll put in the link below, because it's definitely really, really apparent for today. And when I was stopping it, I actually just was, as I was walking here, breathing in the fresh air, getting outside, I was also saying, what am I appreciative for? Because I think if we can change our focus from expectations to appreciation, and not to say that you're expecting something at this moment, because I actually haven't been, but I feel like rather than mellowing in it and sitting in the sulk, is just to relate and say, what are you appreciative of right now? I'm so grateful for Ava. Honestly, she's a blessing in disguise. I'm so grateful we get to have this time together. I have a man that is taking care of us, which is so great. And we're looking after ourselves too. We have this period where we can actually just appreciate ourselves and look at and get to know each other, and listen to each other's needs. And, just grateful that we have a roof over our head, that we have a stroller, that we could go outside, that I can even drive, for those moms that have C-sections, they're not even able to drive. The fact that, I had that independence to just get out and drive, I'm really grateful. And, for those that are watching this that have had a C-section, that, you are a little bit more homebound, maybe it's asking other people to drive you around, or it's, getting your partner to drive you out, or it's just going out for a walk around the block, just still get outside. Don't make any excuse saying, oh, I can't do this, just find another way. And, you know, that's the biggest thing is, you know, every woman has a different pregnancy journey. This is the one that I'm on. And, you know, that's the one that you're on, is just find another way. You know, don't let one thing stop you. That's the biggest thing. And that's even with me right now is, you know what, change the focus, look at what you're appreciative of, and then reassess. And honestly, it's not going to last forever. That's the one thing I keep telling myself as well. It's like, soak up this time. You know, I look at when I'm walking out here now, I see other kids and they're already like, on like biking with their parents on like one of those two-wheeler bikes, or they're biking on their own, or they're running up the hills. It's like, you know what, Ava will be there very soon, and we'll be able to have that freedom, and I won't have to have her, you know, skin to skin on me all the time, and she'll be able to communicate with me and talk and tell me what she wants, and we'll be able to have a conversation, and we'll be able to walk, and she'll be able to walk beside me. And, you know, that will all come in time, and it's not to rush it. It's just to enjoy this time that we have together right now. So I hope this sheds some lights on you. And also, you know, just even to put your comments down below of like, what did you do to get over this phase? Because I feel like I'm not the only mom that kind of is like, you know, just not as energetic as their normal selves. And it's okay, you know, and it's just not to marinate in it. This is just where you absorb it, you stop it, and you focus on what actually you are grateful for, and then move on. You know, this is, we have so much to be grateful for and so much to be appreciative of. And if we focus on that, then we get to enjoy the whole beauty of it. So I'm going to get back to it. As Ava's slowly waking up, I'll flip the camera over so you guys can see her. I'll just actually turn it around, see her really quickly. Look at her all bundled up. So cute. Anyways, I won't disturb her. That's number one rule too. Don't wake a sleeping baby. That's what it is. That's what my wife told me. And I was like, oh really? At that time, I already had woken a sleeping baby before Ava in that case. So anyways, have an amazing day. Hope this resonates with you guys and helps out and gives you a little bit less pressure to know that you're not on your own. Okay, take care. Bye.